Rather, I would also be just echoing I said, Mama, we are here suffering with the council. And I want to assure you, in the Market Act, this market is supposed to pay tax generated from lockups, stores, and stores. We pay every month money which goes to council, but council has abandoned the market activities. On the gambling issue, before I go to gambling issue, maybe I can give you a background of these times. 313 vendors, according to our last census we had here. And this market is generating every day 2 tons of garbage. We pay market deals to council, but they had abandoned to remove garbage outside there. So what we resorted, we had to create again another fee, which we call entry fee. Through painful, because they were not meeting their responsibility. So these vendors, that small thing which we have been gathering here, it has been the one which we have been using to pay cleaners in this market, removing garbage outside, paying allowances of security guards, even the sweepers inside here. So the money which has been collected by council, it has not been serving any purpose in this market. So we have been able to this all around. It is so happened that I've been getting some material for the last 10 years in this market. So whatever I'm giving you on a true fact-finding during my tenure as a general secretary. So for all those 10 years we have been suffering, we have been needing all various offices to be helped. Not until when my sister, the RCC, came last time when we had the concern, and I think through her, most of the issues have been resolved. But now, that money is the one which I have been using for daily operations of the market. So the money collected at council, we don't know. We normally ask them for accountability of the money which they collect in the market. They don't reveal it completely. Then another issue which had brought in the scandal of recently. They gave us a new market master. Ever since, let me say, for the last 10 years, we have had 10 market masters. When they see this one is not meeting their interest, immediately they move, they bring another one. And now, this time around, the one whom they had brought had a hidden agenda. There are people who are behind him. They pushed him to the market because he had a hidden agenda to get money and pay those big officials at council. So this time around, we said, no, enough is enough. And we knew that the new RCC who was appointed doesn't need such kind of work. So, good enough, in our resolution at council, we said, no entry fee, because those entry fees was an arrangement of vendors. We stopped and instructed the council to ensure that they meet the daily expenses of the market. But I want to report to you this, Madam RCC. Despite those resolutions we did last time, council has not yet given us a new market master. So right now, as expected, we are the ones still managing the market. But still we are not collecting money on the other side. But chairman has stood as the chairman of the market, is ensuring the daily operations of the market are moving on despite no tax collecting. So we really request your office federal council expertise on the process of appointing the new market master here. Then another issue we are suffering is about water. We had a bill which accumulated during COVID. That bill accumulated to over 100 million during COVID period, because it was only one department which worked during COVID, the ones who are selling foodstuffs, fresh foods. Then the other departments, they were told to remain at home. So during that period, power accumulated, bills accumulated. But still when we came back, council had the task to get the arrears. Even if we did work in COVID, we paid the council. When we came back, council demanded for those for the tax which we didn't pay in COVID. So we thought if they get this money, they are going to offset their own bills. But up to now, they have not paid. So we don't know how these people are working. I think they don't have a way to help this market. That one, I would say it without fear or favor. Then another issue, security of this market. We had to mobilize these local guys. They are the ones who have been keeping this market for all along for the last 10 years. And still, it was through local setup and local arrangement that we have been able to serve each other with for the security guys who have been in this market. So it is of our humble request that if government has any arrangement, they should send us here people who are official and coming from what? From the center. Then there is also another issue on the electricity. Every month, you get a bill of 23 million. That bill of 23 million, the 19 million, 20 million, it is always accumulated by vendors. Then the 3 million, it is for security rights, which is supposed to be paid by council. But I want to assure you, Mama, that for us, we normally pay our 20 million up to you. But what normally causes power shortage here, or disconnection of power in the market, it is because of failure of council to pay their 3 million, which accumulated to 100 million. Yeah, 3.5, sorry. Yeah, they are supposed to pay 3.5. But because of their unwilling to pay their part, that matter had to accumulate up to 100 million. Yet for us here, we have for our arrangement, we normally bring each and every vendor submitter, they pay their 20 million. And up to date, many people don't demand vendors, they demand land. So, it is of our humble appeal to the government that this new act, it is true, it came, and it is giving the mother council or city council powers to manage this market. And it is exonerating the vendors setting or the vendors executive to carry all the activities of the market. But for us as vendors, putting us in the hands of council is like pushing us to suffer.
Yes.
That's what I would say. Because whenever you give moral powers to council, you're like telling the vendors that you can suffer. They are not willing to ensure that the administration of the market goes well. So our request is that if government has any arrangement to empower the vendors themselves through their executive to manage these markets, it would be better. Because this new act came last year, and I want to assure you, I've been a general secretary for the last 10 years, and I also subscribe as a market union board member. I have never been consulted on the new law, the new act which came. Because right now it exonerates vendors' participation. It only talks about section 8, which have low input into the administration of the market. So our humble request is that the government should look into that, because these councils are not willing to carry out the vendors. People are suffering with water during rainy season, and the council is not helping us completely. So we request the government of His Excellency Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, because some of us, we are cadres, and it makes us very, 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 very worried to see that the president has had a will to improve on the livelihood of vendors who are operating in markets, and the people responsible to maintain these markets have completely refused to maintain them completely. This market is only 10 years down, but I'm telling you the defects which this market have desires again to put a separate budget to be renovated. So we'll be those few. I beg to Asumin, and I would like to introduce to you a market executive committee members and section heads. If you're a section head, you can stand. We do request three offices that this time the new appointment of Madam Asumin and the deputy, it is, they are serving the true service of His Excellency, what he desires to be done for the local person. And with those few remarks, I beg the entire team of Mbale Central Market for the good work that he has done for us. We say, Asante Sana! You are tender!